Tennis Guys, and welcome to my channel. So this is my next car vlog, and now I'm sitting in my car and I'm going to pick up the new Head Boom version 2 tennis rackets for my review for the Sportega store, and I hope I will get the MP and the Pro version. So that's what I'm promised to receive. And I have another topic to talk about in today's car vlog, and I'm going back to a topic that took attention many of you. It is a quite controversial topic, but I believe it's important that we discuss it in a more detailed way. So I've made a video about how soft tennis rackets are actually, or can cause you arm injuries, that soft tennis rackets with a low RA stiffness can produce some fatigue to your arm, can make your arm feel tired, essentially because the dwell time of the tennis ball is longer on a tennis racket with a lower stiffness. So that's the problem. And someone is pushing me with an Audi car behind, so I'm getting a little bit frustrated now of these people who have fast cars and they feel like they can do anything on the streets. So I will not get pushed away from the line just because some prick with a white Audi with a high horsepower car is trying to push me away from the road. So the problem with soft tennis racket, as someone posted under my video, which I will also put a link in the description too, so you can, let's say, get on the track a little bit. Some of you stated that if you buy a soft tennis racket, then essentially a soft tennis racket gets, during time, of course, gets even softer, right? So if you buy a 60 RA tennis racket, it will probably get under 60 RA pretty soon. So that's the first thing that you need to count, right? So a soft tennis racket will never be stiffer. It will get only softer. So that's the first thing. The next thing, and that's right from the start, when you buy a soft tennis racket, you realize that you have a better control, you have a better feel, and so on and so on. But is it the most important thing for you to get really better feel, to get better control? Do you think that you need that in your tennis? Maybe you will love to have more free power than more control. So I suggest that when you are buying a new tennis racket, always focus on what are your preferences. The next thing, and that really made me to make this video, is a myth, kind of myth, that is around pro level tennis rackets. So people think that pro stock tennis rackets are soft because the pro level players, they need the most control, they need the most dwell time, and so on. But that's not really the case. I was watching once again a great video from Tennis Spin, where Harry is introducing and talking about the Bayardo Wilson machine that can do anything with a tennis racket. It can measure, of course, weight, swing weight, balance, but also it can measure twist power or twist how the frame twists. It can also measure the stiffness, but not only the, let's say, the horizontal stiffness, but also the vertical bending, and so on and so on. And they've had their Wilson Pro Staff RF97 from Roger Federer back in the days. It was a quite an old model. I believe he played with this racket like 15 years ago, and they had the opportunity to measure all the parameters and also the bending and the stiffness and the RA. And the racket was strung still with the, let's say, with the original string, and they measured 70 RA on a super control oriented racket from Roger Federer, strung, so probably unstrung even more, 72 probably, 73. So that's a stiffness of a stock Babolat pure drive rackets, or some of the pure aero, older pure aero rackets. Very stiff, isn't it, for a control oriented frame, for someone who has one of the most exceptional techniques, probably the best technique in the history of the sport. So isn't that interesting? Isn't that showing us that soft tennis rackets are, in my opinion, a product of modern society? You know, today everything is somehow rotating about softness. Everything is soft, and men are soft, and everyone is soft, and everyone is nice and gentle, and everyone is like yoo-hoo-hoo, sun, flowers, it's beautiful, everything is... No, stiff is better, guys. Stiff, at least medium stiff, is better. 65 RA, why not? I have a 65 RA Artengo racket, and I think I hit the sweet spot. Maybe even the frame could be a little bit stiffer. 66, 67, 68 RA, no problem with that. And you might be thinking, okay, Roger Federer 70 RA tennis racket, he used a natural gut. Of course he used a natural gut, but with a ALU power string. So a combination of the, let's say, stiff string and super soft, the most natural stiff natural string that you might buy. So now I'm here at the DPD, and I will go, and I will go for the rackets I need to receive for the review. So let's go for it. Point the camera so you can see me when I'm going out of with the package.
Serious, man. You cannot be serious.
So I'm here, and sounds like tennis rackets. So that was smooth.
So here it is. Here are the rackets from the Sportega store.
So today it was the last day when I could pick up the package. But yeah, sometimes it's like that. I didn't at the time. I was on a ski vacation last week, and yeah, I have the Booms version 2, so I can do the test of the quality control. Of course, you can expect that very soon. And now back to the topic of the soft tennis racket. So soft, everything is soft nowadays. You need soft this and that, and some tennis shoes are super soft, super comfortable, but for a long period of time the cushioning wears off pretty fast. And that's another topic, or that's another problem, I believe. And that's another, is it a scam from the manufacturers? So you buy a 62RA tennis racket. In a year it's a 60RA tennis racket, maybe even less for someone who is hitting with the racket extensively. And you somehow get tired of the frame, because you feel that maybe there's something missing. It's not that great as it was at the beginning. So you change the racket. So this can lead to changing a tennis racket more often than when if it was stiff. So I remember back in the days that I could play with a racket for 5 years with the Pure Drive, and it was still stiff. It felt still stiff. It felt still very powerful. It felt still very competent. But now with the soft tennis rackets, you lose the free power even more and more. When you already buy a product that has not the free power. So that's another thing. So that's just my talking, my questioning. Are these companies doing this, softening the frames, just to make you buy new tennis racket even more often? Just you get tired of the frame, you get literally tired of it, because the racket makes you also feel tired. So that's another issue probably I have with the soft tennis rackets. And guys, you might be thinking, I can't play with a stiff tennis racket, it gives me tennis elbow and so on. I don't think that's a valid answer. You can soften the frame with a soft poly. Nowadays, as I was talking about soft, how things get soft, there is softness in everything. So softer polys are there. They are very comfortable. You have plenty of choices. You can lower the tension and you can just make the racket feel like it is softer, but it still has the stiff response, which is something I always enjoyed, that the response with a stiff racket on the ball is immediate. There is no delay, there is no extra, let's say, dwell time that sacrifices the free power. There is no extra this tiredness feel, that you feel tired because the ball is staying on the strings for a longer period of time, and you are kind of fighting with the ball. And you know, for some people maybe this is good, the dragging feel, that you are dragging the ball. But I don't think that super soft tennis rackets are the way to go. So let me know in the comments, what do you think about this topic, soft tennis rackets versus stiff tennis rackets? Is it better to have a compromise, like I was talking about the 65 RA, or do you like stiff tennis rackets, very stiff tennis rackets from Babolat, or soft tennis rackets like nowadays are that many companies are doing. And of course, stay tuned for more about the Booms version 2, the Boom MP and Boom Pro, because there will be a quality control test. There will be some talking about the frames, the previous generation, which I feel it was fantastic. It was a great launch that was, in my opinion, maybe badly promoted by Head or wrongly promoted, but I really enjoy the first generation of the Boom, so I can't wait to test the new one. So guys, thank you so much for watching, and as always, enjoy tennis, play tennis, watch tennis every time, every day, and don't forget to enjoy the maneuverability. Bye guys.
You can't be serious, man. You cannot be serious. That ball was on the line.